Hi there. As you can see, I just did my workout. We're at 3 of 10 right now. And we're playing as Rembrandt. Going into level number 6. We've opened the second flashback level, and that one you're Swan. Which is cool. And all of these missions going up to the movie, you really only get to play as Swan in that one level because you are playing through him through just about all of the movie. This one starts out, Cleon wants to send you to finish that tag that you started before. And you start out with 2 cans of paint. You start out, and it takes 3 to finish this burner. There's a paint dealer right behind it. So you can run around Coney and mug somebody to get the extra $5. Tip the tag, or you can just go take the can of paint from it, which is what I'm going to do right here. If you look on the map, you can see there's another side quest out in Coney. It's another turf invasion. And I think I'm going to save that one for the next side mission quest, because that particular turf invasion, there's 13 guys. You have 13 attackers, and Rembrandt is not a strong fighter. The guy that you get to play as in the next level of this game is a really strong fighter, and he's just such a cool character. I'm going to save that. So, tag's done. And on the way out, as Rembrandt's walking away, he sees a poster. Kind of gets his attention. There's a writer's showdown, which him being the artist of the group, he's got to get in on, right? Going into Soho. Soho is an area in the middle of New York City that's famous for artists. It's a haven for artists. It started out as an industrial district that had all these buildings with a lot of space, and then as time went on, a lot of that deteriorated, and you had all these empty buildings where the lofts at the top were just huge and vast. They weren't like regular apartments, they were just big open spaces attracting a lot of artists. That ain't cool, brother. Understand? But seeing as you said the Warriors would show, the thing here that kind of trips me out the most about that, the gang that runs the turf, Soho, they're a bunch of mimes. The hi-hats are a bunch of mimes. And in a way, I guess that kind of makes sense, being that it's the art capital of New York. Okay, it kind of makes sense that the street gang would be a bunch of mimes. I don't think that necessarily makes it any less ridiculous. But it kind of makes sense, I guess. You know what I mean? You know, it sounds kind of stupid, but okay, yeah. I guess that makes sense. What makes the hi-hats so dangerous is that most of them carry knives. And knives are really dangerous weapons in this game. Even your strongest characters like Cleon and Kochi's can't take too many knife shots. Too many shots with a knife. But this is a really cool board. And you got Snow and Ajax running with you. You got Cowboy over there too. He's not real strong, but Ajax and Snow are pretty strong fighters. It's pretty cool, the hi-hats. So, hello, get out of the way. All right. Showdown's up here on the right. If you look all the way down the street, onto the left, there's a flash dealer down there. So if you mug a couple people, you can get some flash. You won't really want... You really don't need it here. Welcome to the Soho Writers Showdown! this guy, you'll see him again. You only see him in levels where there's lots of tagging, lots of spraying going on. For whatever reason, this guy's really in on the scene. I'm guessing he's from Brooklyn because that's where this whole scene that came from. Alright, okay, I'll get back to that in a minute. This board, there are cans of paint just randomly stashed all over the place. You gotta gather 5 cans of paint and hit your tag, which is right over there on the right. You can handle this one of two ways. I could run up here, grab this can of paint, and then run down and hit the first tag, and then go get the next one. The way I like to do it is I like to run around, get all the paint first, and then hit that giant burner you have to hit in one shot. It's a 5-piece burner. You got... So that's just my approach. You can do it however you want to. Next one's up here, which... Nah. And to pick up a stupid garbage can, and I'm not going to get it before the Eliminators do. The guys in the yellow jackets are the Eliminators. Whoa, hello. Not a dick. Alright, well, back up to the first place we went. Right at 4 right now. And as you can see, the other gangs are already hitting their tags. But if you have them all at once and run and hit it all at once... Oh, hello. Excuse me. And there was a Panzer already. There was a Panzer already there, so I'm not going to hit that one either. But I like to get 6 cans of paint in case you screw one up. Which, like I said in an earlier post, these huge burners have really weird shapes. It's not just the W's that we've been hitting so far. Like this one, we haven't seen yet. This one isn't so bad. This one's okay. I hit watch my back because these guys are running around punching each other and fighting each other, and they will attack you as you're trying to do this. And this one looks kind of complicated. It's not, really. Because of the big loops. And this one again. We've seen this one before. I really don't like this one. Yeah, got it that time. Got it in one shot. The high score. Yeah, this one. This sucks. I don't like this one either. Yeah, see? And that's the one I screw up. The high score for this level is 8,000. Which shouldn't be a problem. Because there's so many tags in this level that if you hit them right, if you get them in one shot, you shouldn't have any problem hitting 8,000. Rembrandt's the man. See him looking all cocky.
That's it. The contest is finished. The best rider showed he ain't no toy, and he do not.
Best rider showed he ain't no toy. And there's the hi-hats. A bunch of mine. Kind of strange, I think. But the leader here, Chatterbox, who's just a big fat clown, his whole crew is a bunch of mimes. You see the Panzers, I guess, all come in triplets. This guy's crew are all dressed like mimes, and he's just a big fat clown. With a stutter. The hi-hats. You see the hi-hats briefly in the beginning of the movie. When the credits are rolling and you see all these gangs getting on the subway, Chatterbox is not in the film. They made this guy up strictly for the game. And there's another mission coming up here a couple levels from now where we're going to be seeing these guys again. But this guy invited all these people onto his turf for this showdown, then comes out. I'm going to run up here real quick just to show you. There is a can of flash behind this trailer over here. It's in the corner. It's in the very far corner. Then you run back up, there's a switch we've got to hit. on the other end. Get up there. Hey, they followed me. There's a switch way at the other end. You hit the switch and wait for the elevator. But I want to get a hat first. Preferably a white hat so you can see it really clear. Alright, we've got 30 seconds before the elevator shows up. The thing that bums me out hardcore about this game is this character right here, Snow. Is one of the original warriors from the movie. Every one of the other warriors have their own mission, at least one. This is it, right here. This is all you get to play as Snow in this short little part right here. They really don't get heavy into his character. In this backstory, they don't. By the time you get to the movies, to the movie itself, you've seen so much of all the other characters that you really care what happens to them. They don't give you a whole lot about Snow. Come on, get up. I'll put the hat back on. But just a big brawl. Very cool. So we'll get the knife. I'd like to show you why knives are so dangerous. Even if you're the really strong characters. Yeah, there it is. One shot kill. One shot, you're dead. Really dangerous weapon. That's what makes the hi-hats so dangerous. Got really bummed out about the Snow character. Wish they would have been put more into him. They didn't really give you anything about him. So this part here, I like to tell my guys to stop here because they get in your way. They keep running back and forth. You pick up these bricks and you throw them at the pulley up there. You don't actually throw them at Chatterbox himself, which the very first time I ever played this game, I kept throwing them directly at Chatterbox. And I'm going, this isn't working, nothing's happening. And he's down. Chatterbox! And tell you what, for a bunch of mimes, these guys sure do have a lot to say. And this part coming up here, the very first time you ever play this game, this part can frustrate the shit out of you. It's really cool once you got the timing and everything down. But I remembered, you're running across the rooftops here trying to get away from the hi-hats and you have to time the jumps. Hello, move, motherfucker. You have to time these jumps just right, because if they catch up with you, the hi-hats dish out a lot more damage. They kill you really quickly if they catch you up here. And you have to jump across the rooftops to get away from them. Hit this fence. Hit this fence. Jump up on top of here. Got Cowboy in front of me. But I was falling off the rooftops forever on this when I first started. And Cowboy seriously needs to get out of my way. There's the fence down here. I didn't hit it right. Got a small opening to get up there. Plus through there, up there. And then you jump through this greenhouse. I like how they slow the camera down for the greenhouse. It looks really cool. And keep going. After this, we should be out of here. Now, of course, you know, all of your guys made that jump, but apparently none of the hi-hats could. Alright, see this big empty loft right here? That's what I was talking about earlier. That's what Soho's known for, is these big empty lofts that artists took over and just created. Some guys created some incredible art, and others created shit that looks like this. And look at this sick weirdo. This is Chatterbox's form of art. It's a big, naked painting of himself. A big, fat guy in clown makeup. That's his version of art. But, like I said, high score is 8,000. I like to hit all the tags before, I mean, this is timed. We have like 2 minutes and 26 seconds to finish this. And if you hit Mayhem, your boys just smash the place up. If they wreck it before you finish the tags, then it's over. So before we get right to the end, if we don't have the high score yet, then I'll tell them to stop, but... It's a picture of the Mona Lisa with clown makeup on. Very cool. And look at that. Dude. Chatterbox is a sick-ass weirdo. This is what he calls art. And there's... didn't get that one. Not that it matters, we already hit the high score. I'm gonna hit them all anyway. Why not? Fuck it. Just gonna hit them all anyway. But you got sledgehammers all over the place to smash up. Smash up everything and, dude, look at that. You know what I mean? That's art. This guy is a sick-ass weirdo. Yeah, look at that. It's a big naked picture of himself, even with his penis hanging out. It's a big fat guy in clown makeup, naked. And come on, almost missed that. Alright, one more left. Alright, there's Chatterbox as the thinker. Big fat naked Chatterbox as the thinker. And very cool, got that. Destroy this shit! And now they can just wreck the place up. Look at this. That's just sick. And over here we have big fat naked Chatterbox Jesus. Hanging on the cross. And that's pretty much the end. That's the end of this board. Really cool, though. Got the whole showdown in the beginning. Got the running segment across the rooftops, which is fun once you get the hang of it. But anyway, this is the end of this one. The next one is really awesome. I'll see you guys then. Please click like and subscribe.